Yeah, you should be good.
Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to our Arts Alive concert for January. So I guess I should wish everyone a happy 2022, since I haven't seen most of you in a while, and this is the new year, so a happy and healthy new year to all of you. And I also want to thank the friends of the library for sponsoring our concert. They do this for us all year, so we get one Sunday a month of beautiful music. And especially today when it's so cold out, we can just sit in the comfort of our own homes and enjoy a lovely afternoon. I do want to let you know what's coming up next month for our February concert. It's a Valentine's concert, yep, right around the corner. It also will be a virtual concert, so you can sign up online like you did for today's concert. We're having Maureen Christine. She is a concert vocalist, and she will be performing some romantic songs for us in honor of Valentine's Day on Sunday, February 20th at 2 p.m. She will be accompanied by Michael Bazin. He's a highly regarded woodwind player. He plays saxophone, flute, and clarinet. I'm just going to give you the titles of the rest of the programs I have for January, and you can go online and look at them and hopefully join us for some of them. They're all virtual, so again, you'll just be given the Zoom link after you register. On Wednesday, January 12th at 7 p.m., we have The Codebreaker and the POW. On Thursday, January 20th at 6:30, a little bit earlier start, 6:30, Understanding Your Aura. You'll learn what an aura is and how to determine what yours is. Sounds like fun. On Thursday, January 27th at 7 p.m., we will be having Unsolved Hollywood Murders. So, something for everyone in the month of January. So we need to get started on today's concert because I know you're really going to enjoy it. Mark Valenti has been with us several times before, and the concert is always beautiful, and he always has great descriptions of the music or the composers we're listening to. Today he'll be performing an eclectic mix of classical music, piano pieces. He received his Master of Music at Northwestern and his Bachelor of Music at the Philadelphia Music Academy. Mark performs on classical radio. He has performed in jazz collaborations and has given solo recitals all over the world. Currently he lives in Chicago and teaches from his studio there. So I know you're going to enjoy the concert, so let's get started. Please welcome Mark Valenti.
Good afternoon, everyone. I have a wide variety of classical piano music for you today. I'm going to start with a sonata by Franz Schubert. Schubert is famous for his songs for voice and piano because he has a very tuneful, lyrical style. And this piece for piano solo is no exception. The first movement has these long, flowing melodies, and the second movement is very slow and tranquil and very poetic. And the third movement, he kind of hams it up a little with a Viennese waltz kind of rhythm, showing off a little bit of his virtuosic piano writing. He wrote this when he was 22 years old for a pretty young lady of 18 years old. This is the sonata in A major by Franz Schubert.
Thank you.
Thank you.
That was the sonata in A major by Franz Schubert. Next, I'm going to switch it up a little. I'm going to change the order of the program just slightly. I'm going to do the Rachmaninoff preludes next. And these are preludes are short little pieces that kind of use one little idea over and over. So the first one, you'll hear this roaming left hand accompaniment accompanying this very lyrical melody. And the second one, this very lilting rhythm, goes throughout several different transformations throughout, and the final one has a very dramatic and impetuous quintessential Rachmaninoff feel. These are three preludes by Rachmaninoff. Thank you. Three Preludes by Serge Rachmaninoff. And now I have for you another sonata by Samuel Barber, the American composer. Sonata is a term that you hear a lot in music. It's a kind of a pattern that the composition follows, kind of like a sonnet in poem. There's a certain scheme to the outline that that the artist will follow, more just for his own creative imagination, not necessarily need to be aware of it, and it's a little too technical to go into right now anyway. But you'll see how much the sonata has developed in over 100 years since the Schubert sonata I played a minute ago. This sounds like Dracula music to me. It sounds like music that Dracula would have written for the soundtrack of his own movie. So the first theme, the first movement has kind of outlines the themes. You'll hear this, what I call stalker theme, kind of a march-like rhythm, sinister, and a lamenting, regretful theme, and the bat theme, this real flitty, fluttering kind of thing throughout. And he kind of introduces those themes and plays with them. The second movement is pure flitty, fluttering bat theme throughout, darting about all these different figures. The third movement is the lament, where it sounds like he's regretting his predicament. And the fourth movement, he kind of pulls all the stops out and kind of back out on the prowl. So this is the sonata by Samuel Barber. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
is the sonata by Samuel Barber. And that should put some hair on your chest. Next I have, and finally, I have a piece by Claude Debussy, is known as an impressionist composer because he kind of painted pictures with his music. This piece, he paints a picture of a very exotic island, maybe in the South Sea, South Pacific. Very easy to hear the wind, surf, and sand depicted throughout, all sorts of swirly, watery kinds of sounds that were very much a hallmark of Debussy's style. This is a very exotic and quixotic piece. This is The Isle of Joy by Claude Debussy.
Thank you.
was The Isle of Joy by Claude Debussy. Hope you enjoyed the selections and have a nice day.